Hello. In this video, I shall be discussing the analysis of a topic. The topic is need to reform counting the COVID toll in India. So there must be some reforms coming up in counting the COVID deaths in India. So this is a topic about mortality database, improving mortality database in India. Because a mortality database is a very important thing as it gives the extent of the pandemic. One can know the extent of pandemic only based on the counting of COVID toll. And this will be given out through national total. For that reason, we go with district-wise estimates of deaths. This is one good way forward for the topic. WHO gave out a classification, World Health Organization, based on the mortality database that each country is giving it. So we all give our database to WHO, all the countries. So based on the data that each country is giving, it sorted out three categories of countries. The first category of countries or those which give good data, that means which is closer to real numbers. The second type are those who give acceptable data, plus or minus with few differences. They give some acceptable data, not very good data, but some acceptable death rate of COVID-19. The third group of countries are those who give data that is not at all available or not at all usable through any source. So these countries are India and China. So they constitute, we know, to 1/3 of the world population. So this is causing a huge discrepancy in knowing the real numbers of the COVID-19 deaths in the world to WHO. So this means that data not available or usable, not usable, is that the estimates of these countries are by external agencies. Only external agencies do the estimates, that too through an indirect approach. So there are so many variables that these indirect approaches have. So there is no standard data in getting from these countries of India and China about COVID-19 deaths. So for that reason, India must come up with some reforms for counting the COVID toll. Before going to India, we'll see some global estimates what they speak about the COVID death toll. The first global estimate is by World Mortality Database. It is the largest international database which took 89 countries into consideration, and it calculated the mortality in those countries because of COVID-19. The report showed two major findings. The first one is the real COVID deaths are 1.6 times much higher than what is reported from all the countries. So all the countries gave wrong reports or lesser reports of death. The next finding is undercounting of deaths is much higher in countries other than these 89. So it conducted estimates of 89 countries, but other countries other than these 89 countries showed even much higher number of deaths when compared to what is reported. So all of these countries throughout the world, we can know out of World Mortality Database report that they are showing undercounting or lesser number of deaths than what actually happened because of COVID-19. The next institute is Institute for Health Metrics and Evaluation, IHEA. It gave out a report that by May 3rd, 2021, there were 6.93 million deaths. But all the countries put together, they gave 3.24 million deaths only. So this is reported, but this is the actual estimated numbers. So this is nearly twice to what is reported. So this is a huge difference. Even India, there is a huge difference in reported and the real. That is, India constitutes to 10% of these 6.93 million deaths when it is estimated by IHEA. That means India showed 6,54,395 deaths. But what India reported is 3 times lesser to these numbers. That means that there is a huge difference than reality, between reality and the reported. And India stands second to US, which recorded 0.9 million deaths. So the first country with huge number of deaths is US, the second one is India, but India showed 3 times lesser to the real numbers of deaths. So this is some estimation by IHEA. So all of these show that there is a huge difference or problem in giving the real numbers out about COVID-19 deaths. But we cannot only blame the governments and the countries, because teasing out cause-specific deaths is a difficult task. That means COVID-specific deaths. Only deaths that happened because of COVID-19, to tease them out, to sort them out, to differentiate from normal deaths or kidney failures or heart attacks or etc. other deaths is a very difficult task, that too when COVID-19 is a very sudden pandemic. So because of this, separating these COVID-19 deaths from normal deaths is a very difficult problem. So only the governments are not to be blamed, but even the pandemic itself, the very nature is very tough. So these are some global estimates which showed far difference, far which showed a huge difference in the reports and the real. Coming to India, for data for India, we'll rely on some crude estimates so far, which are not very accurate, but we are taking them into consideration. The first one is Kerala. For example, these are three examples. There are many of these kind. Kerala showed a decline in deaths in 2020. So can this be acceptable? Not at all, because COVID-19 has come up in 2020. Not just India, but the whole world saw a huge increase in deaths. But Kerala shows there is a decline in death in 2020 when compared to previous years. So there is a wrong registration system over there. The next one is Mumbai Municipal Corporation. It came up with a report that 22% of excess deaths happened in 2020. But we know that Mumbai is the worst hit areas in India to COVID-19. But it just showed 22% excess of deaths. This must be even more. The reality is even more. So because of that, this is also not reliable. The next one is CMIE Private Limited. That is Center for Monitoring Indian Economy. This is a private company. It came up with a report that in 2019, there were a set number of deaths, but in 2020, they got doubled. But this report included, these deaths included, deaths due to all causes. So due to different causes, not just COVID specific. So we cannot rely on CMIE report also for bringing out COVID deaths. So based on these crude estimates, it is clear that in India, we don't have a standard estimation system. We cannot rely on these estimates. So different trends of data are causing different estimates, and this is causing a huge confusion to policymakers and even to the public. So policymakers can come up with a good policy only when the information is accurate. Only when they have good accurate numbers, they can come up with policy decisions and estimations and all. But that is not happening, which is a big problem to India. So what is the way forward to this? Here are some options we can employ. A good vital registration system for deaths, for mortality must come up in India. And statistical department must come up with some sophisticated statistical approach for mortality recording and all. And there has to be a baseline. That baseline depends on mean and standard error. So this is a topic in statistics that based on the last 5 years deaths, we calculate a mean number of death mean. And based on that mean, we see the standard error that is happening in this particular year. So that error will be COVID death. So like that, we can define a baseline. This is one important step. The next one is CRS. The full form of it is Civil Registration System. CRS has to be employed in each district. In each district, for example, there is an experiment of CRS in Faridabad recently in Haryana. And this numbers of death through CRS showed very closer numbers to what the real deaths are. So this is proved effective in Faridabad. So CRS system has to be employed in each district. So this will bring out district-wise estimation, which is a very good thing. So if we go with higher levels of estimation, there will be problems. So if we go with least district-wise, smallest unit district-wise level, we can gather all the districts-wise estimates and bring to a national total, which is accurate to closer to real numbers and accurate. The last option could be defining the estimates using 2020 data. So we already have 2020 estimates of COVID-19 deaths. So we can refine, we can bring some positive parameters into these estimates, or we can remove some unnecessary parameters to these estimates. We can refine the estimates of 2020 data for 2021 data estimates to be very accurate. So these are some of the reforms that we can bring in counting the COVID toll in India, so that we can give good numbers to WHO, so that we'll be in good data list, not in third list of data not available and all. We can improve our standards of policy making also through good numbers of accurate numbers of death toll and all. So this is about need to reform counting the COVID toll in India. And thank you.